So today I'm going to show you how I made this marbleized fondant covered cake. It's great for birthdays or just because. So let's start out by making the bow and the flower. So let's roll the fondant through the pasta maker to make it a little bit thinner. Let's just insert a little bit of paper towel here, just so the bow can form. Let's just lay these tails on this egg crate, just to give it a little bit of shape to it. Put a little vein in it. You just have to put it in and lightly press it. And you'll get a nice little vein. Now I want to take each petal and just thin it out just slightly on the edges. Gives it a bit of a more realistic look. I'm going to take another piece, roll it into a little ball here. And make it into a little cone shape. This will be the center of the flower. This is where all the petals will stick to. And let's let all this dry, and then we're gonna move to the next step of the cake. So I almost forgot, but let's go ahead and roll out some green here and make a couple of leaves. So I have these little leaf cutters, they're like plungers. You just put it on and press the little lever and it'll put an impression, sort of like the veiner for the rose petal. Let's set these into the egg crates as well. Give it a little bit of shape. So here I have 3 6-inch round layers of banana cake. So let's go ahead and level them off and shower them with simple syrup. And I have a cut glove on here because, well, just don't want to get cut. And again, the simple syrup is just to keep the cake moist. And it also gives it a nice extra layer of flavor. So let's go ahead and crumb coat the cakes using a vanilla buttercream. I'm using that frosting from the center that kind of squished out. So go ahead and get the sides here. Let's go ahead and pop that in the fridge and let the crumb coat set up. Now let's go ahead and transfer the cake from the work surface to the cake board. So let's pop this into the fridge yet again, just for a couple minutes while I roll out the fondant. So to get that marble pattern, I'm going to take some white fondant and some black fondant. Twist them together. Now each time we do this, we're going to get a different pattern. And we never really know exactly what we're gonna get. But I think this is pretty good. So now let's just curl it up. Let's start rolling it out and see what we get. So there you have it, a nice little marbleized fondant cake. Great for birthdays or any occasion where cake is involved. And I can't quite imagine many occasions where cake wouldn't be welcome. I'm Aaron Glapion, and this is We Dream of Cake.